when we consider the birth process from a physiological perspective in a modern way, we can say it's an involuntary process under the control of archaic brain structures. And physiologists can tell us, in the case of an involuntary process, the point is not to try to help it, you cannot, but you can protect it against some inhibitory factor. The point is to protect an involuntary process. And in the case of birth, scientists today, physiologists, can explain what are the kind of factors a laboring woman has to be protected against. Situation that might increase the level of adrenaline, situation that might stimulate the neocortex, the thinking brain. Thinking brain might take a back seat in a woman. It's never, it's not its business. It can only, the activity of the new brain, of the logical brain of intellect, of the neocortex, can inhibit, can make more difficult basic, vital physiological functions like being birth. So a laboring woman needs to be protected against all factors that might stimulate the thinking brain, the logical brain, the neocortex, particularly language the enemy when giving birth, light. Today we know that melatonin, the darkness hormone, works with oxytocin, the main hormone in childbirth, they work together, and all attention enhancing situations. For example, feeling observed, when you feel observed, you stimulate your neocortex. Important not to feel observed. The perception of a possible danger, you have to pay attention. So that's what we have to understand today. It's a new way of thinking, the key word being protection. This has to be understood at a cultural level. It's not just among those practicing in a hospital or elsewhere. It has to be understood at a cultural level, and in particular in groups promoting what they call natural childbirth.